الله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أما بعد فيا أيها الناس اتقوا الله وسارعوا إلى مغفرته ورضاه فإنه من مات على الحق فقد رشد وإنه من مات على الباطل فقد خاب وخسر خسر الدنيا وخسر الآخرة وذلك هو الخسران المبين. Every country in the world and every religion, maybe every company, they have a vision. And this vision is very important. Of course, the vision will be different from one country to another country. America has vision different than Russia and China. European countries have different vision than Muslims country, if they have. Judaism has different vision than Islam. Christianity has different vision than Judaism. The point that I'm trying to say today is you have to have clear vision, clear ideology. Otherwise, the nations, the countries, the companies, even the Sunday schools, they are not going to progress. Now, there is a study just released from Pennsylvania, University of Pennsylvania. They studied which of these countries in the world are aqwa iqtisadan, best economy, aqwa quwa askariya, strongest military power, strongest media, who controls other countries. Number one country comes, this country, United States. Then Russia, China, then other group, Germany, UK, France. Then another group, India, Brazil, Sweden. Then another group, Poland, and Yugoslavia, and others. The question is, where are the Muslims' countries? Where are the Arab countries? You see them in the bottom. The study says why United States is number one on the list. Because they have a clear vision. You know, they have check and balance. Even in my cancer center, when I go to work, I see it. Our vision is to cure cancer. So we are all 1,000 workers. We have one vision. Now, America has very strong vision. Even your kids, before they go to school, they were watching TV. American vision and aims are in the cartoons. It's cartoon movies and children movies. It's there. Even in the schools. Your child, they say that your child will go to school for 900 hours per year. How many hours your child, my child, is watching the TV in America? 1,023 hours. So watching TV more than even going to school. They say that if your child is 6 years old, he or she will watch TV for 2 hours, in average. That's the study. If your child is 8 to 18, it's 4 hours. What's happening? Our brain, the children's brain, are bombarded with the vision. I'm not saying America has bad vision. No. Your children, they go to public school, they teach them very good. They teach them respect time, be clean. Don't lie, follow the rules, all kind of things, organization, They are very organized. But all these teachings and visions is concentrating on materialistic. No spiritual thing. No ruh. This is why my son, when I ask him, I want to be a billionaire. I want to buy the biggest palace. I want to buy the most important or most expensive car. This is, I don't blame him. That is the teaching. They teach your kids, your youth, to be selfish. Yes, selfish. Competition. And this is a problematic, of course. There are three major questions in this life. Three major questions. Number one question is, من أين أتينا? Where did we come from? The West, they don't care. They concentrate on the second. Why we are here in this life? This is the second question. And the third, أين نذهب بعد الموت? Where are we going after we die? They don't care. Muslims, they have very good answers. For the first one, Allah has created us. We are here because Allah has created us. And when we die, we know. If we are good people, we go to Jannah. If we are not good, we may visit the hellfire. When they concentrate on matter, the people here, they will grow up with this vision. يقول الشيخ النابلسي, Sheikh Nablusi, one of the good, great scholars of Syria, he said, I read about 400 famous people in the world. 400. These are very famous people who are achieving excellence. He said most of them, they committed suicide. Because they have achieved everything. I remember there was a great famous guy who built the bridge in Istanbul. The bridge that connects the East and the West. On the day of the opening of the bridge, he committed suicide. When they went to his room in the hotel, they found a piece of paper. He said, I have achieved my dream. I have achieved everything. This is very dangerous because they don't think about where they are going after death. In America, it's like a clock. It's everyone knows. In the morning, they do coffee. They don't pray Fajr prayer. They do coffee. They take breakfast. Even sometimes they take breakfast while they are driving. They drive to work for 1 hour, 2 hours. I have a technician who lives up north. She comes every day. At 12 o'clock, they take a break. It's a robot. They finish at 5. They drive another 1 hour, 2 hours. They watch TV. They eat dinner. They drink alcohol. They listen to the news. Khalas. No Isha prayer, no night prayer. There's nothing, no spiritual. How about us? What is our vision? This is a great question for us. What is you Muslim? What's your vision? In fact, I asked this question to my parents, to my teachers, to my scholars. And everyone gives me a different vision. The Sahaba fi asr al-Nubuwa in the time of the Prophet ﷺ, they had clear vision. They know. They know. From where we came, Allah has created us. Why we are here, لِمَاذَ خُلِقْنَا? To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عِبَادَةُ وَكَوْنَكْ خَلِيفَةً And your job is khalifa. لِتَعْمِيرَ الْأَرْضِ To build this land. And to help people. And to make people happy. And you in return become happy. And then when we die, we go to Jannah. That is the whole Islamic vision. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, number 30. We go and open the Quran. He gives us the mission of a Muslim. And he gave you the job title. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وإذ قال ربك وإذ قال ربك للملائكة إني جاعل في الأرض خليفة. Allah سبحانه وتعالى told the angels, I'm going to create a khalifa. Now, khalifa, I'm Arab. I don't understand it that much. I went to translation. 7-8 translations. Number one, I will establish on earth one who shall inherit it. So you inherit that's a monotheistic explanation. I will create a vicegerent. You are the vicegerent of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will create a trustee. You are a trustee of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who can build the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, he did not say, I will create Adam. I will create Eve. I will create Muhammad or Hassan or Khadija. Or even Muslim or a Jew. He gave you the title. The job title that we are supposed to do on this earth, Khalifa. To build this land. To work hard. To help people. To make them happy. To be happy and die. Now, this comes with الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran 51 times الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Translation, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those who believe, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, the translation goes, who make good deeds. In Surah, in fact, every 10 pages in the Quran, you will see عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Hud, Yunus, Maryam, Kahf, Luqman, Fussilat, Bayna, Shu'ara, Sa'd, Inshiqaq, Teen, Al-Asr, everything. More than 282 الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا in the Quran. More than 315 عَمِلُوا. عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ 100. So what is عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ? أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على محمد وعلى آله الطاهرين الطيبين. Can we come forward a little bit? There are a lot of people coming, standing outside. الذين آمنوا, the one who believe, inshallah we are all believers because we believe in the Quran, we believe in the message of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and we are Muslims. وعملوا الصالحات, the people who do good deeds. So when I ask my mother, my grandmother, what should I do, عَمْلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ? I want to be among the people who do عَمْلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ. Read Quran, pray. I go to my mentor, what's عَمْلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ? You give sadaqah, you make qiyam al-layl, you read Quran. It doesn't make sense, you know why? الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, to be a believer, you cannot skip prayer. If you don't pray, you are not a believer. If you don't fast, you are not a believer. If you don't read Quran, you are not a believer. If you don't fast, you go Hajj. So what is عَمِلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ then? عَمِلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ comes the explanation in Surah Al-Kahf. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us, read Surah Al-Kahf every Friday. What is in Surah Al-Kahf? You find Al-Amil Al-Salihat. You remember Dhul-Qarnayn. Dhul-Qarnayn was a good man. It's not only a good man, Amil Al-Salihat, he was inventor. He discovered something to help humanity. So they told him, the village, they told him, we need your help, you are a good person. Can you do a dam between those two mountains? He said, yes. So you go and read it, and now عَمِلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ there. And now the Khalifa is there. In Surah Al-Kahf, Ayah 96. Then he told him, آتوني زبر الحديد. You want me to make a dam? Give me, bring me blocks of iron. Okay. حتى إذا ساوى بين الصدفين, level it between the two mountains. قال انفخوا حتى إذا جعله نارا. Then he made the iron very hot like fire. Then he said, قال آتوني أفرغ عليه قطرة. Give me, bring me copper, brass. So he put the brass on the melted iron. And he came with a combination. This is Quran 1400 years ago. He made this, the strongest combination of two metals. And he built the dam. Now, Dr. Zaghlul al-Najjar, he is a member of the medical science, international medical science of Quran. He was talking about this. And I am a member also. And there were some non-Muslims and scientists. And he said that, I don't know if you combine iron with copper with brass, would it be strong? And wallahi, one scientist from Germany, his specialty is mineral. He stood up and he said, this is the best combination that we have in our factory. And it is not only strong or strongest, but it's very smooth and can be easy done. So the amal al-salih, this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, you have to do something in this life significant. Don't tell me you are praying, because that's part of amnu. Don't tell me you are fasting. Don't tell me you are building a masjid. إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا. This is part of our iman. Even donation to the masjid, it is not that the significant thing of khalifa is to do something significant on earth. Build a, contribute in building a hospital, Islamic school, help a person from nothing and make him something. There are so many Muslims that are in need. Wallahi, I have a doctor. I don't mention his name. He is from this community. He brings orphans from overseas. Let them live in his apartment. Feed them. Teach them. Spend on them. Finish college. Send him back. Bring another one. This is why Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he was so smart. Wallahi, now I understand. He said, if Allah subhanahu, if Muslims have only Surah Al-Asr, then one of the shortest surah in the Quran. He said, if Muslims, if only have Surah Al-Asr, that would have been sufficed. That would be enough for them. So then when I looked, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات. So he combined آمنوا. You are a good Muslim, good believer, you pray, you fast, you go hajj, amal al-salihat. You are a khalifa on earth. You are a khalifa, you are vicegerent, you are the builder of this land. In summary, our vision, that I would like, they didn't teach us at our school. I'm from a Muslim country. Nobody taught us what's our vision. This slogan says, Allah khalaqani, Allah has created me. Why? To build this land and help people and make them happy. And in return, I'll be the happiest person, so when I die, I go to Jannah. That is our slogan. We have to teach our kids this vision, otherwise they will be growing as other non-Muslims. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واهدنا وعافنا واعف عنا اللهم انت ربي لا اله الا انت او الله يو ار ماي لورد ذير از نو جاد اكسبت يو خلقتني وانا عبدك وعلى عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت يو هاف كرييتد مي اند اي ام يور سيرفنت اي هولد يور كوفيننت اس فار از اي كان اعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت اي سيك ريفيوج ان يو فروم ذا ايفل اوف وات اي هاف دان وأبوء لك بنعمتك علي. I acknowledge the favors, all the favors that you have bestowed on me. وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي ذنبي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. O Allah, forgive me. O Allah, pardon me. For none but you has the power to forgive. وأقم الصلاة يرحمني.